Hello student, welcome back to our video lecture on a data structure. Today we'll see a very important data structure called as stack. In this video lecture I had covered a definition of the stack, the operation performed on a stack and its applications. As I explained in the previous video, data structure is divided into two categories, linear data structure and a non-linear data structure. Stack is an example for linear data structure. Then what is a linear data structure? In a linear data structure, the elements are stored in sequence one after the another and a continuous memory is allocated for these elements. In the same way, the elements which are stored in the stack are in sequence and a continuous memory is allocated for these elements. Let's move to a definition of the data structure. A data structure is a ordered list in which the insertion and deletion are made at the one end called the top. So what is a stack here? A stack is a data structure where you can insert and delete the element by using only one end, and that is called as a top. So from the top only you are going to insert the element, and if you want to delete the element you are going to delete from the top only. The stack is called last in first out collection, means that the thing or a data that you add at the first will be removed last. Example for stack are the books kept on a table. So if you want to keep a one more book, you are going to keep on the top only. Next, if you want to take a book from this stack, the last book will be taken first. Or you can take a example as a plates arranged on a table. The plate which is on the top will be taken first. So if you want to keep one more plate, you are going to keep on the top only. If you want to take a plate from the stack, the last plate will be taken first. Or you can I can give one more example for a stack, that is bangles in a hand. So you are going to insert and you are going to take a bangles from only one end, and the bangle which is inserted at the end will be taken first. So that is also an example for stack. Let's see the operation performed on a stack. Here we are going to perform two operations, push and pop operation. Push operation is used to insert item into the stack. Suppose you want to insert element into the stack, then you are going to perform out push operation. Suppose you are going to delete the item from the stack, then you are going to perform out pop operation. Here the element top, it represents the current location of the data in the stack. As I said, you are going to insert element into the stack from top only, and you are going to pop the element from the stack from top only. So top represents what? It is the current location of a data in a stack. Let us see the operations on a stack by taking example. Assume that the stack which I constructed has a maximum size 5. Means what? The 5 elements I can insert or delete into the stack. And this 5 is called as the maximum size of a stack. The number of elements to be added should not exceed the maximum size of the stack. If the size of the stack is 5, so I can add only 5 elements into the stack. If I try to add 7-8 elements, then the stack will move to a condition called as stack overflow. Size is 5, and if I am trying to insert more than 5 elements, then stack will be in the overflow condition. Similarly, you cannot remove the elements beyond the base of the stack. So if stack is already empty and you are performing a pop operation, you are trying to delete element from the stack, then it will move to a condition called as stack underflow condition. So two condition you remember here. One is stack overflow, another one is stack underflow. Stack overflow, when it happen, when you are trying to insert a element more than a capacity or a maximum size of the stack. And stack underflow, when this condition raise, when you try to delete the element from the stack, when stack is in a empty state. So take an example here. In this example, I had shown that stack and the operations of the stack. Check out the first statement here. The first statement, it shows the initial stack value. So initial stack value is what? Empty, means no element is present in the stack. What will be the top value at that time? It will be minus. Next, so here the empty stack is shown. After that, I am going to perform a push operation. So here I am pushing a element A into the stack. So what will be the stack content now? Stack has one element, that is A. Check out the top value here. Last value of top was minus 1. Now it get incremented by 1. It become a 0. After that, again I am going to push another element. So top has a second element. And what is the top value here? Top always pointing to this location. So top value is what? 2. Next, again I am going to push an element into the stack. So that time, see, 0th element of the stack is A, 1st element of the stack is B, and 2nd element of the stack is C. After that, I am going to perform a pop operation. Pop means I am going to take element from the stack. So here, I am inserting and deleting element from only one end, that end is called as a top. So the element, see, what is the top value here? Top is pointing to which location? It is pointing to a second location. So when I perform the pop operation, so which element get out of the stack? The first last element, which is inserted. So C I am going to take out. After that, I am going to push a D element. So again, the top value get incremented by 1. Last time it was 1, now it become a 2. When I push another element, it become a 3 now. After that, when I perform the pop operation, E will come out of this stack. Then when I perform again a pop operation, D will come out of the stack, and so on. So after deleting all the element of the stack, what will be the stack state? Stack will be in a empty state, means no element present in the stack. So that time, what will be the top value here? It is minus 1. So this is about the push and pop operation on a stack. Next we'll see the algorithm and a particular code implementation. So here algorithm, see, which operation you are performing? You are inserting element into the stack. That is nothing but a push operation you are performing. So what is the first step here? Check whether stack is full. So stack is full means stack reached its maximum condition. When stack will be full? When it reached the maximum condition. Okay, so maximum size. Assume that the size I had given 5. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So it start storing the element from 0th location. So 0 to 4 location, it will store the element. Okay, so that's why here we are checking whether a top value is equal to size minus 1. 5 minus 1, 4. If it is the case, then it indicate what? The stack is full. Means already top is pointing to what? The maximum size of the stack. That time, it will display the message that stack is overflow. And it will come out of the function. If the stack is not full, then you are going to increment what? The top value by 1. And you are going to insert the element, the new element in that location. So stack top equal to what? Value. Before that, you are going to increment top value by 1. Check out the code implementation for the same. Void push. So I am going to insert one element into the stack. So before insertion, I will check whether stack is overflow or no. So what is the condition here? If top is greater than or equal to max, maximum stack size minus 1. If that is the case, I am going to print a message, stack is full. If it is underflow, means the still the an insert element in a stack, that time you are going to increment top value by 1, then you are going to insert a new element in that position of the stack. So this is about the code implementation of push operation. Next, pop operation. So pop operation, before you delete an element from the stack, you should check out what, whether stack has reached its stack is in an empty state or not. So if it is in an empty state, you are not going to perform the pop operation. If not, you are going to perform, you are going to take an element from the stack. So here, first step is what? You are checking whether stack is empty or not. So empty means what will be the top value here? Minus 1. First you are checking what? Top equal to minus 1. If it is minus 1, then you are not going to perform a pop operation. You are going to raise a error message that deletion is not possible and you are going to come out of the function. If not, then if stack is not empty, then you are going to delete the top of the stack element. So stack top element you are going to delete, and after you are going to delete, and after deletion you are going to decrement the top value by 1. So check out here, it is shown in the diagram. Initially top is pointing to the element, the last element of the stack. So when you perform the pop operation, you are going to take this 15 out of the stack. Then after taking, you are going to decrement the top value by 1. Now where the top is pointing, it is pointing to a 12. Next, when you take 12 out of the stack, again you are going to decrement what, top value by 1. Now it starts pointing to a 10, and so on. Check out the code implementation for the same. So I had written the pop operation here. If top equal to minus 1, then you are going to print a message what, stack is empty. You are not going to perform any pop operation, you are directly coming out of this. Else the popped element is A of top. Actually here it is written toss, so it is not toss, it is top. So A of top element you are going to pop. After that you are going to decrement this top value by 1, that is top minus minus. So this is about the pop operation. Next, if you want to display the element of the stack, so first you are going to check what, whether the top equal to minus 1, means whether you are checking whether stack is empty or no. If it is not empty, then you are going to use a for loop, because n elements are stored in the stack. So you are going to print all those elements. So if you are printing more than one element, obviously you are going to make use of a for loop here. So what is the for loop content? So here I is initialized to what, the top value. So the last element is pointed by this top. So I equal to top, I is greater than or equal to 0. See, so what is the stack size here? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 elements are there. So I equal to top means, what is the top value here? I equal to 5. 5 is greater than or equal to 0. So till it reach the 0, you are going to print the element. And each time you are not incrementing, you are decrementing I value by 1, because I is pointing to a highest location. Now you go on decrement this I value. Decrementation of I is nothing but decrementation of a top value. And you are go on print the array elements. So this is about the display function of the stack. Next, you can see the application of the stack. The first, a simple application of a stack is to reverse the given string. So stack elements, so you are going to read the string left to right single character at a time. You are going to insert those elements in the stack. Then if you want to make the reverse of this, you start reading the element from the stack. So first the top value will get red and print on a screen. So it will print what? E. Then S, R, E, V, E, R. So you'll get what? The reverse of an initial string. So this is a very simple application of a stack. Next, the second application is checking the validity of an expression containing nested parentheses. Suppose you are matching a parenthesis, means for every open bracket, the close bracket should be there. So condition you are checking, then you can make use of a stack here. So you are go on inserting the parenthesis. So once you get the matched parenthesis, you are going to pop that from the stack. Next, the main application of a stack is evaluation of, it comes in the picture of evaluating the arithmetic expression. So it is used to evaluate the arithmetic expression, or you can use a stack to convert the infix expression to a postfix or a prefix. So infix notation is nothing but the general way of writing the arithmetic expression is known as the infix notation. So here operator come between the operand. Prefix means the operator come first, then the operand. Postfix means operand first, then operator. So it is used in the evaluation process. Stack is used in the evaluation process. Assume that this is a one expression, that is 2 plus 4 minus 1 into 3. So according to the priority, whatever things enclosed in the bracket will be evaluated first. Same thing is done by the stack. So here first 2 is pushed. It will read the expression from left to right. So the first it will read 2, then plus. After that, so it will insert only the elements, that is number, into the stack. Then 4 will come. After that, minus 1. Then it will evaluate 4 minus 1 because it is in a bracket. It will be 3 then. Next, it will read the next operand and operator. So into 3 is there. So it will read push 3. Then 3 into 3, it will become a 9. Next, 9 plus 2, it will be 11. So you are going to see all this with an example. So this is all about stack and its operations. I hope you understood this concept. Thank you.